I ran on a platform of restoring cooperation at City Hall and bringing people together.
Everyone, please, everybody, please respect everybody's right to speak and be heard. So, if
Thank
you wouldn't
Madam
mind.
Chair. I believe that cooperation will begin with a strong leadership team, and I encourage my fellow. Rec Commission to guide the Hall property park naming. I just want to make sure that that guide, that word, means that they're making recommendations to council. And if that is the case, then I happily allow them to explore that option. On number two, it looks like we're in favor of evaluating the cost of installing artificial turf. Okay. Boy, Mayor Bond, I'm going to do your job here. Sorry, I've taken over.
Hey, that's okay, just so we get it done.
And we're okay on allowing the commission to do their outreach surveys. I didn't really hear. Yes, okay. And it sounds like allowing the commission to do the initial review with the exception of Moonlight Beach. You don't want that except you're okay?
They're actually already doing Moonlight Beach.
They are doing Moonlight Beach.
They already
Beach.
Do that.
Oh,
so
I see.
This would be expanding it to all citywide.
Okay. Got it. Great. Wonderful. And we were all a no on the investigation of open space.
Well, not a no.
Not a no, but
there,
we have
going to be agendized so that everybody's on the
correct.
Same page.
Correct. No, I've been very impressed coming on board here in December and receiving the briefings from all the departments and understanding more than I understood before about the inner workings of the city. And I'm really impressed. And I firmly believe that you get what you pay for. And we have a bargain with Phil because we have a balanced budget. We have fully funded budget reserves. We have a super funded budget stabilization reserve. Public safety remains a top priority. As mentioned before, we're moving ahead with several very large capital improvement projects. We have a lot to be proud of here in Encinitas. And when I hear other electeds from surrounding cities and the challenges that they're going through with budget cuts and things, boy, we just don't have that here in Encinitas. And so I think it's important to note that Phil has done an incredible job leading the city and leading the staff. I know that when he's here in City Hall, the staff respects him on such a level that it never is that top-down leadership. And that's a sign of a great leader. So I really do respect that. And I also respect work outside of City Hall. I'm a telecommuter. I guess that's the new term here tonight. 365 days out of the year, if that's how many days there are in the year anymore. Who knows? And so I know that I'm never physically in our office, but I run our office. I'm the CFO for our company, and the work gets done. And the burden of proof here was whether the contract had been fulfilled and or whether there's a failure to fulfill the contract, and there is absolutely no evidence to support that. So I support Stocks and the motion, and I really do appreciate the work, Phil, that you've done for the city. Hate to be the naysayer, but it seems like a common trend around here that we always jump to an extreme when we identify a problem. I guess I'm more in the middle. When I see a problem, I try to think of an easy fix to the situation, and obviously establishing some criteria is important to me. And tonight I think we owe it to the community as a council to see if there's consensus on the dais that the draft land use and housing policy as presented today is officially dead, and that we're operating on a clean slate approach. That would be excellent information for a decision-making body. So I commute several times a day, and I'd mentioned that rarely a day goes by where I'm not being tailgated driving the speed limit on that road, especially in the 40-mile-an-hour section of Quail Gardens Drive. And people are very angry with me as they drive behind me following the speed limit. And I've noticed that there routinely is a deputy stationed between San Ygito Heritage Museum and the Botanical Gardens. That to me indicates that some citations are being issued there, because otherwise why would they spend their time parked up in that area? And the driver behind me is always very thankful when they finally see the sheriff deputy parked there and they avoid a ticket. My question for you this evening,
personally
terrified, Sherry, after hearing you look me in the eye and say, we're going to catch you. I won't be driving that road anymore, so sorry to the residents on Saxony. I'll be using your street. I was hoping that we could, I don't know if we have to modify the motion or perhaps we could just seek consensus. I'd like for the people that are here tonight, I'm hoping for an item brought back to council for consideration of some safer crossing in that area. We have several unique features there. And, you know, personally, when I cross it, it's a bit like that game of Frogger with the three kids trying to cross. And I think we could do a great service to our residents, especially since we have trails on both sides and the different museums and gardens that are out there. So perhaps just a discussion on what we can do to make crossing safer. I don't know if we can.
Well, Deputy Mayor, why don't you?
Well, my typical approach is not to jump to the regulation point, because I do believe that we can find other solutions, perhaps, that are more effective. And certainly I see that there might be a challenge in direction moving forward. But I'd say, you know, let's explore some other options before we engage in